This is Jacqueline. Welcome to our presentation about Assessment 2, Part A. UNS Library faces a large number of student visitors every day. Based on the feedback from the first assessment, I realized that I needed to clarify the problem face, the issue with user needs, and anything in persona should provide information. Therefore, I redefined the problem, which is the lack of confidence and attention to the library collective by a user group of students. As part of the user will study with their peers or complete group tasks after entering to the library. They are likely to break the safety rules and remove their masks when talking with their friends. It can be a problem for other users. Also, because the library is not well signed, it is difficult for users to find a proper seat in a short time, and they have to walk a long way in the library to find a seat within crowd. Thus, my smart assistant has two main goals upon entering the library. The first one, to visualize the user's level of safety compliance. The second one is to help the user find the available seat. Then, hypothesis. A library standard board guidance program. The signboard can display the QR code of the program and user scan it by camera to locate the soft wire. If the user uses the soft wire by scanning, it will reduce the contact to other, and it will not force users to download. If users do not have a cell phone or inconvenient situation, the sign can be used by touch. Fewer and clearly visible buttons help users focus on the key points and complete the process quickly. Student users can quickly find a safety and appropriate place according to their needs. Multiple usage modes made it easy to use and help users to complete their tasks. This is a prototype I created about the design. The software can achieve two tasks. The first one, quick check-in. The second one, space navigation. The first page is the home page through which user can log in and fill in basic information when creating an account for future registration. Then, the next page, there are two icons. The first one can be positioned to two check-in methods, scanning code or filling contact information. The second image locates some safety illustration and news about COVID-19 in real time. When the user navigates to the button of the page, this check-in icon can also be located. After completing the registration, the user is asked to take a short questionnaire about the social safety rules. Then the check-in process is complete. Regarding the questionnaire, I may change this in the future. The first time, I planned to connect the face recognition system in different areas of the library to gather face mask wearing status of user in the area. However, this method was rejected by many users who tested it to invasive of privacy. About the second task, space navigation. Users can click on the safety illustration button to visualize the number of users in different areas, the percentage of mask worn, and whether the system analyzes a safe environment. Further clicking will give you the specific retail and health alert. And at the bottom of the page, there is also a navigate icon that shows the users directly the usage of each facility on the floor. For the user test, I invited at a total of 10 student users to help me with the user test. To summarize the question on the surface. The first one is, the back button is too small and hard to use. The safety illustrations are too long and hard to focus. The questionnaire must make users lose patience. Some users want to know more about safety, and some just want to know the highlight of the news. Then there is my challenges in part B. If I don't want to rely fully on my phone to function, but to use a touchpad, how can I solve the safety problem due to the repeated use of the touchpad? Are there other ways to avoid touching? What could be a better way to collect the degree of compliance with the safety rules of the user, other than collecting the face recognition system and questionnaires? Continue to improve the surface and complete high fidelity.